Hey, it's the Fort Worth Playboy.
And my Playboy's Bunny.
Welcome to our podcast where we discuss pickup, game, relationships.
And sex.
She sounds like that in person, too. Kind of breathy.
When I'm not cackling.
Yeah, that's funny. Basic training. We're going through a lot of the rules. You want to have basic rules in your head.
Yeah.
So you don't have to make decisions.
It's true.
Because decision making is fatiguing. So that's why, like in my how to build a dating system, some things just become automatic.
And it's true.
A big question we get is, when going out to dinner, do you pull out the chair for your date?
Yeah.
And
it's a real hot topic of debate, yeah, too. And I'm not sure why, but I guess I was just raised. I was raised with a dad who always pulls chairs out, who always opens car doors. And
I was raised
in environments where that was a norm.
Yeah. I've always thought of it as in higher end dining and fine dining, you absolutely do.
Yeah. And at weddings, like you said.
Exactly. At events.
Yeah.
Yes. It's complete. And it's like Bunny said, the key here is just to make it smooth. And what it does is it allows you to control the room. So, you know, when you approach a table, it's going to be hostess, the girl, you, or just you, and you're leading her. You grab the chair that you want her to sit in, the one that's with the back to the room, preferably.
Yeah.
That way she's not distracted. She can look straight at you, and the only thing behind you is a wall. And allows you to sit facing the room so you can, for best safety and security.
Yeah.
And you can see anything approaching. You should become so used to this, mm-hmm, that it feels weird to have your back to a room or a door.
Oh, yeah. No, men don't ever need to have their back to the room and the door.
And she can't tell you anything that's coming up on you. So you want to say, hey, have a seat here. And then you pull out the chair. She, you know, plants her butt into it. Then you move it forward. And then you can sit where you want. That way, it's easy. You don't have to, you know, direct her. Or, you know, she's like all over the place. And that's how you do it. I never think about, I'm sure I do this. I don't anymore.
I was going to say, I cannot think of a single time in our existence that you have pulled a chair out for
me. Lot of this, okay, you guys, I think probably a lot of that comes from over time. And here's the deal, and this is the positive and negative.
Yeah.
You know, you start doing asshole game, and it becomes such a part of you. But the good thing about pulling a chair out when you're running asshole game is it contrasts. You know what I mean?
That's true.
You know, and girls like contrast. He's kind of an asshole, but he knows what he's doing.
Yeah.
You know, so.
It's true. But I do think, you know, I've posed this question on Twitter before, you know, to pull out the chair or not to pull out the chair, and kind of let guys run with it. And it was a very divisive topic. Either I would never pull out a chair. That's a simp thing to do. Blah, blah, blah.
That's interesting.
Or, of course, it's good manners. You pull out the chair. It's a non-issue. But I think that the key here is you're doing it to control the situation, to control your safety and hers, because you're responsible for her, and to just control, to set the frame, to continue, just, it's one more.
You're calling the shot.
Yeah, it's one more step in you directing the date.
And when you're dealing with modern women, especially like career girls,
yeah,
they know men's etiquette, and so sometimes they will try to like take charge, you know, I can take care of myself. And then when you supersede that and kind of get ahead of them on it, it makes their life so much easier.
Because career girls, I think especially, they make, they're probably the first line of defense is to kind of challenge things.
Yeah.
But then, once they actually meet a guy who has control of the situation, where for once they don't have to make all the decisions, they actually really enjoy it.
They really can relax
and appreciate it.
Yeah, it's huge. It's huge. Because the contrast between that and what they have to deal with in their normal day-to-day are big.
Yeah.
They can be themselves.
Exactly.
They can be a girl.
But, I mean, our primary suggestion is you're not running to trip all over yourself to be the gentleman and to pull her chair out and all this stuff. You're doing it to control the frame. You're doing it particularly because you have good manners and you know how to present yourself. You do it in events and nice venues and nice restaurants. And then, I mean, if you're at Applebee's, you don't have to pull her chair out. I mean, you don't have to. It's just, it's a nice thing to do, and it's a way for you to stay in charge, which is a huge factor.
Perfect.
Yeah. If you haven't already picked up Basic Training 1 and or 2, please do so in the description box down below. Fort Worth put a lot of effort into making sure that your dating etiquette is on point. A lot of the tips in these books are ones that theoretically people know, theoretically people have been shown, but they don't often, once you kind of get into adulthood, you tend to forget them.
Yes.
And unless you practice them, you really don't think about it.
Yes.
So they seem very simple. That's why they're called basic training rules, but they will make a world of difference in your dating and your relationships. So we want you to win. If you like this podcast, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Bye!